I never did forgive you for that time you hit me on the head with a marble, Tijan, Nina saying to me, my sister. But I will never hold it against you, but you hit me on the head. I had, too. But if with Repulsion, champion of the turf, she wouldn't be sane without a lump in her head. Luckily, I used a regular marble, not the ball bearing. I flew into an awful rage because Ma had sent her up to clean my room Saturday morning, 11 o'clock, when smells of boiling's on stove. And I was settled for my game and cried when I saw the meet with 40,000 people on hand. It was going to be postponed. But she was adamant, so I confessed before the judgment of the eternities I threw a marble. Synod, owned by S&S Stables, right at the top of her head. She ran down crying. I was severely jostled by my irate mother and made to sit and sulk in the porch a while. Attendez, machin. Frappez de Zeus, la tête comme ça. Serais jamais heureux d'être un homme comme ça. Go on outside, bad. Hitting your sister in the head like that. You'll be happy being a man like that. Doubtful that I ever grew up, too. Bien, Nin, I'd say. J'aurais dû pas faire ça. Well, Nin, I shouldn't have done that. Well, we come to St. John Baptist Church, St. John the Baptist Church. She wants to go in for a second to see if the third grade girls at St. Joseph's for girls are having their Lenten exercises. Wants to check on her girlfriend's little sister. Nin and I gaped at the drugstore window inside where neat black and white tiles made a golden sunfloor for the drugstore and where the strawberry ice cream sodas were foaming at the top in pink bubbleless mist froth at the slavering mouth of some idle traveling salesman with the sales samples on the stool, soda in glass sitting in steel glass grip with round clinky gilder bottom, a solid huge soda, old-fashioned with a barbershop mustache on it. Then I sure wished we could get some of that. Yum, yum. Joy of the morning was particularly keen and painful in the marble slab counter where a little soda was freshly spilled. We romped up on Moody Street. We passed several regular journeyman Canadian grocery stores crowded with women like our parents, buying hamburger and huge pork chops of the prime to serve with hot mashed potatoes in a plate in which also hot pork chop fat is floating around beautiful with luminescent golds to mix with a mash of hot patate, add pepper. In fact, Ned and I grow hungry remembering all our long hikes to the Royal, looking at sodas, walking and seeing the women buying sausage and butter and eggs in the grocery store. Boy, moi j'aimerais bien faire. Boy. Nin says, rubbing her dress over her belly. Boy, me, I'd like real soon, right away. Un bon ragout boulette, bien chaud, a good pork ball stew, very hot. Dans mon assiette, my plate. Prends ma fourchette, je le mâche ensemble. I take my fork and I mash it together. Les boules de viande molle. The balls of soft meat, the potatoes, the carrots, the good fat juice. After that, I put a lot of butter on my bread and a big glass of milk. For dessert, I put in, we'd have a big hot pie of cherry with whipped cream. My sister says, the next morning for breakfast, we'd have some nice big crepes with maple syrup. Sausages, well cooked, sitting in the plate, hot, with a big, beautiful glass of milk. Chocolate milk, I yell. No, she said, that's not good. White milk. Boy, it's gonna be good. And I say, in the supper of that day, what's we gonna have? She says, don't know. She's already turned her attention to other things. So I say, me, I want a big bowl of pâté de foie with meat spread. And hot beans like tonight's sad night, a pot of beans, good fresh Belgian bread, lots of butter on my bread, lard in my beans, brown, just a little hot, with all that good hot ham that falls apart when you put your fork in it. For dessert, I want a big, beautiful cake, hot, made by Mama, with peaches and the juice from the can and some whipped cream. That or Al's Pa's favorite, whipped cream with date pie.